drama.
Boy, this is hellfire and brimstone when these two get together.
Relive the excitement.
Oh, man, Trojan, where are you at? He's got number.
Relive the rumble with a special rebroadcast of highlights from the most controversial Royal Rumble in WWF history. Plus, Ahmed Johnson and The Undertaker team up to battle Mankind and the Nation of Domination. It's a very special Royal Rumble Raw, and it's this Monday.
That's tomorrow night right here on the USA Network. 2 big hours tomorrow night right here on the USA Network.
This is scheduled for one fall. Making his way into the ring from Zaragoza, Mexico, Avismo Negro.
Well, there you see him, Avismo Negro. He's a newcomer to the AAA promotion, a high flyer, a risk taker, and here is his opponent.
His opponent, coming down the aisle, here is El Hijo de Perro Aguayo.
The 17-year-old son of the Mexican legend Perro Aguayo. Meet Avismo Negro here on Sunday Morning Superstars. And don't forget, folks, still to come, The Undertaker one-on-one with Wild Man Mark Merrill.
I can't wait to see this match. These guys are two high flyers, and we'll be back for it pretty soon.
Next up,
right in that chest.
Wrestling Federation is on tour and is headed towards an arena near you. This afternoon, we hit the Molson Center in Montreal, and tonight we invade Ottawa's Correll Center. This Friday, February 7th, we take over the Igloo in Pittsburgh. On Saturday, February 8th, we make our way to Bethlehem Stabler Arena. 1 week from today, February 9th, we land in the Continental Airlines Arena. It's Thursday, February 13th. It's Thursday, Raw Thursday, live in Lowell, Massachusetts. Next Friday, February 14th, we celebrate Valentine's Day in Cincinnati with a massacre. There's only one World Wrestling Federation. Catch it live at an arena near you.
Certainly great to see the WWF live, and this Friday in Pittsburgh is going to be a very special event as this match gets underway. Two outstanding young competitors in the AAA organization in Mexico trying to make their mark here in the World Wrestling Federation. The masked man, of course, is Avismo Negro. And the other young man, only 17 years of age, the son of Perro Aguayo.
As a matter of fact, that's what El Hijo de Perro Aguayo means, the son of Perro Aguayo, who is the most beloved wrestler right now in the country of Mexico, plans his retirement this year, and his son plans to carry on the family name and tradition. At only 17 years old, he's already got about a year or so under his belt.
Negro with a high-risk maneuver, driving the elbow right into the sternum of young Aguayo. Still to come, The Undertaker one-on-one with Wild Man Mark Merrill. Plus, we're going to take you back to last week on Raw and show you an emotionally charged interview involving Shawn Michaels and a host of WWF superstars that certainly got out of hand.
You saw Aguayo take that fall right on the back of his head. Referee Pepe Casas checking his condition. Pepe Casas, the most popular referee in Mexico, has three sons that are wrestlers: Negro Casas, Heavy Metal, and Felino.
Nice leapfrog there by the masked man. And, oh, good move there as Aguayo was able to land back on his feet. Now there's don't see too many airplane spins, and the counter down into the arm drag.
He tried for that spinning backbreaker, but Aguayo landed on his feet, and now he's been countering Avismo Negro every way. He goes right on his face, and watch Aguayo, he's going to fly.
Aguayo with that tope through the ropes. A suicidal maneuver, using his head as a battering ram. Certainly throwing caution to the wind. That's worth another look there, James Z.
Right there is Aguayo misses the drop kick. He didn't miss this one. He nailed it with all his weight and all the velocity. In Mexico, the luchadors, as they're called, take their craft and their sports so seriously, they'll do anything. They'll put their bodies on the line to win and to make an impression on their opponents and their fans.
Look out. There's a hurricanrana by Avismo Negro taking young Perro Aguayo, the 17-year-old youngster, right off the top. And Negro now going back upstairs. Nothing unusual for this athlete.
And he's got home!
Nobody there. Aguayo has an opportunity here to put the masked man away.
And he's going to try his best to capitalize on it, but I don't know whether... Wait a minute, is this... Yes, it's at the famous Aguayo stomp. That is his father's favorite finishing maneuver.
The leg is hooked, and...
No! I can't believe he got out of that, JR. That is his father's favorite finishing maneuver. The vicious double stomp off the top rope.
Certainly testifying to the toughness of Avismo Negro. Great counter move there. Can he hold him? Worth one, two, and three.
He got it. Over Avismo Negro. You can see on the replay, as Avismo Negro tried that power bomb, Aguayo had the presence of mind to turn it into a pinning combination.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's take you back to Raw. Shawn Michaels had said his piece, so to speak, when an angry Bret Hart joined the, well, he joined the party, so to speak.
Bret Hart, what about it? You've got your chance.
Ooh, here we go. Stay there, McMahon.
Whatever you gotta do to walk out with the World Wrestling Federation Championship belt at WrestleMania, do it. Because you are the one that I wanna beat. Because when I walk out of the Final Four, there's gonna be one man standing once again, and it's gonna be me. And I don't want anybody else. I don't want any excuses. I don't want you to injure yourself. I want you at 100%. Because you are
overlooking Psycho Sid. Aren't you overlooking the match they're going to have on the 13th? One-on-one, the rematch. Sid and Sid could be once again WWF champion.
First time McMahon's ever made sense.
I don't care. I won't discredit Psycho Sid. But I want you to know that I'm going to be rooting for you all the way, because I don't want anything to happen to you. I might even go so far as to say that I'll be watching your back. But let me promise you one thing. As far as it goes for me in the Final Four, I don't have any doubts at all that you'll be stepping in the ring with me if you can hold on to that.
Oh, come on.
And with that having been said, ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce you to another participant involved in the four-man elimination, no disqualification matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, The Undertaker.
Uh-oh. Now maybe we'll get to see some action. I think Bret Hart was scared. Shawn Michaels was glad of it. Come on, Undertaker, get on out here and get things started.
Respect that you earned at last year's Royal Rumble when we fought. You have my respect, but I'm getting sick and tired of how you've been screwed out of the World Wrestling Federation title.
Yeah, me
too. If you want to talk about screwed, you look at my history. You look back at last year's Royal Rumble. That is rightfully mine.
He's got a point.
Now, I've sat back too long, and I've let everybody go their own way. But I think it's time that comes to the dark side.
Ooh.
No longer will I be the hunted, but I will now be the hunter. Which, unfortunately for you, Shawn Michaels, puts you and me at WrestleMania. Give your soul to the Lord, because that belt in your body will belong to me.
And again, it seems as though a number of individuals are overlooking Psycho Sid. However, right now, ladies and gentlemen, yet another participant to join us. He is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Finally, here we go. Here's a guy that's going to come out here and open up a big can of whoopin'. Well, you know what I mean. Come on. Here's a guy that likes to park in handicapped spaces. Pledges money to telethons and then doesn't send it in. I love this guy. Like to give lost people directions and leave out a turn or two. Tell them about it, baby.
Shut up. I may be. Shut up, huh? I may be the toughest SOB in the WWF, but I recognize an ambush when I see it.
You're right.
From where I stand right now, I see three crybabies and little boy Blue. You all sit there and piss and moan about everything you want to. At the final four, I'll wait my opportunity then. No disqualification is right down my alley. I threw both of your over the top rope. Shawn Michaels, you know, son, if you'd have been in there, I'd have done the exact same thing to you. Come February 16th, that's when I'll get mine.
Vader's behind you. Yeah.
No, second thought, I'll whip your right now.
Well, that whooping didn't take place on Raw, but it'll take place in 2 weeks. And in your house, exclusively on pay-per-view, live from Chattanooga, Tennessee's UTC Arena, for the biggest superstars ever in the WWF.